Welcome students, today we will start with the last point, and the last point is oxidation and reduction in day to day life. Now oxidation reduction involves two processes which are very important in our day to day life. These processes are corrosion and other one is rancidity. Okay, first of all we see corrosion. Now you can observe corrosion in our atmosphere and in your nearby and in your daily life. You can observe corrosion so easily when sometime metal pieces are kept openly in environment, then these metal pieces slowly spoil and slowly it decomposes, and there is a deposition of red color layer on the surface of metal. That surface of red color is a compound of metal, which is an oxide of metal. For example, a metal piece is of iron, that red color rust or red color layer which is present on the metal surface is of iron oxide. If there is a copper forms copper hydroxide and copper carbonate. If we kept the silver in the open atmospheric condition, silver reacts with the atmospheric gas, that is hydrogen sulfide, and there is a formation of silver sulfide. That's why because of deposition of silver sulfide on silver, it becomes black in color, or silver becomes blackened. And so many examples of rusting of iron we have. Now what is the definition of corrosion? Corrosion so many times asked in the board exam in the different way. Now easy way to memorize the definition of corrosion is, corrosion is first of all, understand or read this shortcut what is written here, metal. Okay, attack of atmospheric gases and moisture. Okay, this is reactant, this is condition, and this is product. Okay, metal, condition and product. Product is rust, or we can say metal oxide, or we can say metal hydrated oxide. Sometime metal oxide form, sometime hydrated metal oxide will form, and combinedly it is called as rust. Now when metal is kept open in the air, there is attack of atmospheric gases. Atmosphere contains so many gases like carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, oxygen, hydrogen. These are the atmospheric gases, and atmosphere also contains moisture, and these are two necessary conditions, atmospheric gases and moisture. If these two conditions are fulfilled, then corrosion will definitely occur. If these two conditions are not satisfied, corrosion will not take place. Okay, now after this attack of atmospheric gases and moisture, metal will convert into metallic oxide. Means metal will lose its original state and convert into another compound. Now we can say metal is consuming, to form its respective oxide or hydrated oxide. It means metal is slowly eating up by the atmospheric gases and moisture. We can say the process of slowly eating up the metal due to atmospheric gases and moisture and produce rust is called as corrosion. So on this shortcut, on the basis of this shortcut, you can memorize the definition, and on the basis of this shortcut you can also able to write chemical equation of corrosion. Now we have example of corrosion of iron. Now our metal is iron. Now we have taken 2 moles of iron, okay, and oxygen gas is present in our atmosphere and water is also present in our atmosphere, okay. XH2 we have taken because we don't know how much amount of water is present in atmosphere, that's why we have assumed it as X, okay. Now the Fe and oxygen, the moles of oxygen and Fe we can decide, we can arrange or we can calculate these stoichiometry, as we know that the valencies of iron and oxygen that we have studied in the 9th class in the mole concept. Okay, now twice Fe and 3/2 O2, okay, giving rise to Fe2O3XH2O. It is nothing but the rust or hydrated ferric oxide. Which is red color. Okay, now oxygen we are writing 3/2 O2, these 2 will get cancelled and we get 3 oxygens because we want 3 oxygen here, that's why 3 oxygen will combine with 2 iron, that's why we have taken here 3/2 O2. Now by this chemical reaction we can say that this corrosion is a deterioration of metals, and in this corrosion metal loses its luster, its shine and its actual nature. So in this case metals are eating up by the atmospheric gases and moisture, so this is a process of loss. And in our world or in our atmosphere, so many tons of metals are getting wasted by the nature. So this is this process is non-profitable, but sometime corrosion have some useful application also. Now another example, is corrosion of copper. Copper on reaction with carbon dioxide, oxygen and water. All these three reactants are present in atmosphere and copper combines with carbon dioxide and one oxygen, giving rise to copper carbonate. And another copper is combining with H2O and remaining oxygen and will form copper hydroxide. It is a mixture, means copper on corrosion gives a mixture of two compounds that are copper carbonate and copper hydroxide, and the mixture is green in color. This compound is green in color. Okay. Now, third one example, the corrosion of silver or black coating. Sometime we have seen on the surface of silver, we have silver jewelry, and sometimes that silver jewelry becomes black because of silver sulfide. This is silver twice Ag plus hydrogen sulfide gas. Hydrogen sulfide gas present in the atmosphere in low concentration, and silver is also very least reactive, and it will form AgS, silver sulfide, and remaining is what? Hydrogen gas. H2 gas will evolve. Sulfur, valency of sulfur is 2, that's why we have to take Ag2. Ag2S is silver sulfide, which is black color. Now, students, if we want to prevent from corrosion, what we have to do? Now, we have to protect the metal surface. So, we can paint the metal surface. पेंट कर देते हैं तो मेटल सरफेस एटमॉस्फेयर से सेफ हो जाता है, तो करोजन के चांसेस कम हो जाते हैं. वी कैन आल्सो डू अलॉइंग, मींस हम डिफरेंट मेटल को मिक्स कर सकते हैं. ऑन मिक्सिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट मेटल्स, प्रोसेस ऑफ अलॉइंग इन्वॉल्व्स द मिक्सिंग ऑफ टू मेटल्स और मिक्सिंग ऑफ मेटल एंड नॉन मेटल. इट विल रिड्यूस द करोजन परसेंटेज. एंड गैल्वनाइजेशन इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रोसेस बाय विच वी कैन प्रिवेंट द फ्रॉम करोजन. एंड corrosion is a surface phenomena which starts from surface and then goes into bulk. And in advanced studies, it is proposed that corrosion is a electrochemical phenomena, which we will study in higher classes. So the prevention method is painting, alloying, galvanization, okay? And we can also use some different methods like cathodization. For example, a metal which is reactive, then what we will do? We will attach a piece of different metal by welding which is more reactive, and corrosion is taking place at that metal which is more reactive, and less reactive metal will be safe for some time. So these are the methods of prevention.